ready?
Fingers crossed, don't yank the drive shaft to the floor.
Anything?
No, still working. All right, start walking forward slowly.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Wait. Yeah, that did it.
This is one of the most iconic scenes in television history. If you haven't seen this, I will explain. The drug manufacturers tried to destroy a laptop which contained the footage of them cooking a drug. Since it is locked inside an evidence room, they try using a strong electromagnet. Somehow, they are actually successful in destroying the laptop and therefore getting themselves safe. But ultimately, don't forget that it's a television show. So, is that scientifically possible? Can we really destroy the data stored in a hard drive using a powerful magnet? How do the hard drives store data? You might already know what a hard drive looks like. The two primary components are a disk and a read-write head. These disks are generally made of an aluminium alloy and are coated with a thin film of ferromagnetic material on both sides. The read-write head is composed of a thin magnetic blade and is responsible for encrypting and decrypting data on the platter surface. The ferromagnetic material deposited on the surface of the disk can be magnetized in any specific direction. A positive polarization usually represents 1 in binary terms, while negative represents 0. Every time the user saves something or installs an application, an electric current flows through the read-write head, which in turn polarizes the specific region on the platter and encrypts data in binary form. Specialized software installed on motherboard instructs an arm to move the read-write head to specific position on the platter where the required data is stored or is to be stored. This is the simplest explanation on how hard disks store data. While magnetism helps us store all our data, it can also be used to destroy the data permanently. As discussed earlier, data is stored in binary form by magnetizing microscopic domains on the platter surface. Now, if another magnetic field is introduced in a specific distance from the hard drive, the direction of these tiny magnetic domains can be altered. This process of altering or deleting magnetic field is called degaussing. When exposed to the powerful magnetic field of a degausser, the magnetic data on a tape or hard disk is neutralized. Degaussing is the guaranteed form of hard drive erasure. As such, it serves a standard method of data destruction.
It's like 8 feet away. Is this cool? Huh, is this close enough?
It'll work.
Let's go!
Hang on.
Let's just go!
Hang on!
Mr. White, let's get out of here.
Just one minute.
But here, they don't show use of proper degausser, and just using powerful magnets doesn't guarantee the deletion of data. Advancements in forensic science have made it possible to recover data from broken shreds of the hard drive later. So, a proper degaussing is required. Even if the electromagnet created a magnetic field strong enough to degauss the hard drive, factors like thickness of the evidence room wall and the shielding effect produced by the metal door would reduce the overall strength of magnetic field. Even the type of storage device used in the laptop is not mentioned. If the laptop uses solid-state drive instead of hard disk drive, degaussing would have failed. Solid-state drives or SSDs make use of integrated circuits instead of magnetically storing data, so methods like degaussing have no effect on them. So it may or may not be possible if you use magnets to erase unwanted data. Do not try this as it may destroy the whole device itself. Thanks for watching.
Learn something.